Oh, thank you so much.
I think I'll pass the witness at this time, Judge. Thank you.
Anything further, Mr. Greer?
No, Judge. Thank you.
You missed it.
Thank you, Mom.
You want to call your next witness?
Don't.
Raise your hand. Swear the testimony you're about to give in the matter of state of Georgia, first to me, is that the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth that you got?
I do.
Seat for me. Introduce yourself to the court, please, sir.
I'm Tony Wooten.
And how are you employed, Mr. Wooten?
Right now, I'm not. I just left the sheriff's office about 6 weeks ago.
Where do you live?
Live in Dawson County.
I want to direct your attention to August 23rd, 2014. Who employed you on that day?
Dawson County Sheriff's Office.
And how long have you been employed with Dawson County Sheriff's Office on that day?
At that point, probably 16 and a half years.
Okay. And were you a post-certified police officer?
Yes, sir, I was.
And you're still a post-certified?
Yes, sir, I am.
What's a post-certified police officer?
This means I've been through the basic law enforcement academy and I have arrest powers in the state of Georgia.
Now, how long have you been post-certified?
Probably about 17 and a half years.
Did you work in law enforcement prior to the Dawson County Sheriff's Office?
No, sir, I did not.
Okay. Did you encounter the defendant in this case on August 23rd, 2014?
Yes, sir, I did.
All right, where did you encounter her?
Burt's Country Farm.
All right. Is that farm located in Dawson County?
Yes, sir, it is.
Where exactly did you encounter the defendant?
Inside the, what I've learned in the last few days is the gourd area. Basically, with the exit to your eyes, where the speakers would be.
Okay. Were you in uniform?
Oh, well, I was. We have two different uniforms at the sheriff's office. One of them is our typical uniform that's the duty belt that we wear, and we also have an alternate uniform, which a lot of agencies have went to. That uniform is the VDU pants, the tactical khaki style pants, and the polo shirt with the badge and Dawson County Sheriff's Office emblem engraved on it. Also had a badge on my right side next to my gun, which is our policy.
Now, you called it BDU, the title. Can you explain to the court what that means?
It's like a pant that's more made for comfort as far as, like, you know, khaki style. It's not, you know, polyester that we normally wear in the summertime. Polyester gets really hot. There's just certain situations where we wear those type of uniforms. So it's basically like a khaki style pant that's got pockets on it for different things.
Okay. So, were you on duty?
Yes, sir, I was.
Were you being retained or paid any extra by the Fulton Party of Georgia?
No, sir, I was not.
About Burt's Farm, were they giving you any supplement?
No, sir, I was not.
Right. And what was your assignment there at Burt's Farm that day?
Just basically security. You had the opportunity to have the governor, and you had several candidates running for office. And they come to Dawson County. This is not unusual. But actually, the night before, I served with the sheriff's office as security at another event. The prior night, I've done these several times, places where the governor's been, places where there's been actors, just to make sure that nothing happened while they were in our county.
Okay, and were you aware beforehand of this event?
Sometime that week, I was made aware of it.
Did you volunteer to do this?
Yes, I did. Well, I volunteered after being asked, so that's kind of a two-part question. Can I answer that and kind of clarify?
Well, let's go into that. Who asked?
Clint Bearden texted me and asked me. That's typical. I've been asked many times, like I said before, at other events, so I was asked by them. Then, as far as did I ask, then I asked the sheriff if he wanted me to work that event.
Okay. Now, what was the defendant doing when you encountered
her? By the time, when I was approached by Mr. Burt and Clint, when they came over to talk to me about it, she was recording, so she was sitting on the front row from that general area. I don't know what they considered the front row.
All right. Now, you said that. Can you be a little more specific?
Well, toward the front, where the speakers were. I mean, right up front. I don't know if that was the very first row. I don't remember if she was on the first row. I just know that she was up front. I think that was the first row, but I'm not. I couldn't swear to it.
Okay. Now, did you know her?
No.
Can you describe your encounter with Ms. Tisdale for the court, please?
My encounter? Yeah. I went up to Ms. Tisdale. I watched as I forget his name, but the guy who was deceased, that died not long after that situation, he was over there talking to her. And then when he walked off, Clint Bearden walked over and talked to her. when, I believe his name was Mac, when he walked by, I didn't know who Mac was. I said, hey, she's not allowed to videotape her, they've asked for her to stop. At that point, he said, I just tried, good luck.
And let me object to what that person said.
Yeah, but I don't need that, full strike that. I might keep him in the session, but it's not necessary. So you had a conversation with Mr. Burt, is that correct?
Yes.
All right, after that, what happened?
Well, I watched as Clint Reed walked over there and talked to Mrs. Tisdale.
Did you hear about Clint or anything what they're talking about?
Did not.
All right, now after that, what happened?
Well, I watched Clint walk away and kind of looked at me and shrugged his shoulders. I'm not sure where Clint went, but then I went over at that point. We had made the decision that Clint would go first. Obviously, we've been in a situation many times in law enforcement where people may not know that they're not supposed to do something, so when somebody walks over and asks them, they simply stop. I went last simply because I'm a police officer. It's kind of more embarrassing if a police officer walks up and tells you, hey, you can't do something, than it would be if it was somebody else.
You say y'all made the decision about that conversation. Did Johnny Burt ask you to ask Burt to stop recording?
He did, he asked both of us.
Did he tell you what to do she didn't stop recording?
Told me she didn't stop recording, really.
Okay, so you make a decision then, I guess, to approach her. Can you describe how you approached her, where from?
Approached her from the side. If you're facing the stage, I've been to the left. So I approached her, come from the side angle. I was more of a, if you looked at it from a clock perspective, it'd probably be more between the 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock. I wasn't straight in front of her, but I wasn't to the side either. I was kind of the side more towards the side, toward the front, where she was standing as I approached.
Okay. Did you make contact with her?
I did. Ms. Tisdale looked at me as I walked over there and as I walked up to her.
All right, now, did you speak with her?
I did.
What did you tell her?
I told Ms. Tisdale several things. I told her that I was being asked by the owner to come over and tell her that she couldn't record. At what point Ms. Tisdale said, I've spoken with the owner, and I said, I just spoke with the owner. He told me to tell you to stop recording, that you had to leave. I'm with the sheriff's office, and I've been told to come tell you that you have to leave if you don't stop.
All right. Did she reply to that?
She refused again.
Okay. Did you continue your
conversation? Did try again, and I eventually said, I didn't know who she was, but I said, if you don't stop or leave, then you're going to leave me no other choice but to take you out and you'll go to jail.
All right. Now, how long did you converse with her?
I would say probably 25 seconds, maybe 30 at the most, somewhere in that time frame.
Okay. All right. Did she stop recording?
No.
So what did you do?
Well, after I asked three times to try to get her to stop, I reached up and put my left hand in her camera area. It might have been in the front of the camera, it might have been on the camera, somewhere in that general area. I reached with my right hand to her, I believe it'd be her right arm that she's videotaping with, maybe. And I said, come on, you have to leave. And at that point, before I could even start pulling up, she started jumping up. So I went up as she got up at the same time.
Okay. You have the conversation. Was she sitting down?
She was.
And were you standing up?
I was bent over talking to her.
Okay, so you've been over. Can you show how you were bent over? Stand up and show the widow how you were bent over talking to her.
She was like at his location. She'd been closer, obviously, but she was like this computer up at this angle I was leaning forward to talk to her. Because I wasn't talking loud. I expected her to comply, and that to be in. So I didn't want to interrupt anybody else, including the speaker, obviously.
Now, once she's up on her feet, what occurred?
When she gets up facing me. So I've got her arm, and I had to move my other hand from the camera area to her other, to her arm. So I've got both hands on her arm. She's facing me. She's, basically like swinging her arm towards me. So I'm trying to get her out of the place. I have no idea who she is. I have no idea what her intent is for that. My suggestion as a police officer, my best practice at that point was I was already asked to remove her, was to get her safely away from everybody else.
How far away was Governor Jill from her?
Not too far. I would say 5 to 10 feet, maybe, somewhere in that general area. Not far at all.
Is that a concern?
It's obviously always a concern when you're an officer. You're in an event where you have, potential congressmen that's running for office, or state senator, I'm sorry. You have a U.S. congressman, you have a governor. When you have somebody go, start acting like the defendant did in that situation, yeah, it's a concern that you don't know why they're doing that.
Yeah. So, gather up and you can describe what happened next.
Yeah, we start towards the barn area from the gourd area there, and she's She's fighting back. She's trying to push away, almost like to get away, like an intent from other law enforcement when somebody would try to get away and run. Not that I expect her to run, but she was trying to get away from.
Do we object to that speculation or about the state of mind of Ms. Tisdale?
Let me rephrase the question. Based on your experience, have you arrested other people in the course of your 17 and a half years in law enforcement?
Yes.
All right. Were her manners consistent with someone that was complying with your request?
No, sir, not at all.
Well, what were they consistent with?
Someone that would be trying to jerk away and in an attempt to get away from me.
So what occurred after that?
Well, I mean, I've got her by the arm. I've got one arm behind her back, so I'm trying to push her towards the barn area. She's doing things basically almost like she's twisting around. So I know I've heard that I've twisted her around, which is not true. My goal was to go the straight line, closest way from point A to point B, straight line. So I was trying to get her to the barn area away from there. So I'm with the one arm behind her back, I'm pushing her towards that area.
Anytime she strike at you?
She did. In that area outside, I was kicked in the shin several times.
You ever hit in the face by her?
Once we got inside the barn, I believe I was elbowed, not hit, but I was elbowed. I'm still. All
right, now, where was the camera during all this?
It was in her hand, and she still had it in her right hand. When we got inside the, were you asking inside the barn or while we're moving or both?
Let's go back to, you just got up, y'all were moving out. Where's the camera?
Still in her right hand.
All right. As you lead her away from the door shed?
Still in her right hand.
And then you're entering the bar.
Still in the right hand at that point.
All right. Now, did you ask her to cooperate?
I don't remember what was, once we got in the barn, absolutely. Several times I told her to stop fighting. I told her to stop many times.
All right. And did you ever identify yourself by name to
her? I did. Toward the end, as I promised, when I told her if she'd stop resisting and stop fighting, I'd tell her who my name was. I told her I was with the sheriff's office when I approached. When she saw me, she looked directly at me. I had a badge, I had my gun. I told her I was with the sheriff's office at that point. I don't remember, and I testified this to the grand jury, I don't remember if I said at that point, my name is Tony Wooten. But as we got into the barn, I did tell her that when she calmed down, I would tell her. There's time after the videotape is off. There's quite a bit of time before the officers arrive at that point. So during that time, there was a time after the videotape stopped recording where Ms. Tisdale calmed down. At that point, we had several conversations that were more calm, and I explained to her who I was.
But you've seen the video. Was she asking you to identify yourself as you were looking?
She was.
Or did you tell her name at any point there?
Not during the movement time. I mean, I know that may seem for some people, but as a police officer 18 and a half years, you've got somebody fighting you, and they're asking you who you are. I mean, the time to discuss names is not while somebody's trying to resist and potentially try to get away.
Once you get in the barn, can you describe how you secured her?
I did. We come in the barn. I'm somewhat familiar with Burt's Pumpkin Farm. Obviously, I've been there for years, being with the county. There's not a lot of choice. There's a hallway that goes up to the top part, which is, it's a narrow hallway. There's nothing I could do there. So I kind of played things in my head as I was going in. The only area that I knew that I could secure her and keep her from continuing to fight was that area that was the cashier checkout kind of thing, the counter.
All right, so once you had that area, how do you secure her?
I've been over the counter there to basically gain control over her.
How did you do that?
Well, I had one arm behind her back still, so I basically just pushed her over the counter and leaned her up against the counter there.
Now, where was your body in position to her at this time?
Well, when we first come in, obviously, to get her there, I had to be behind her, so that situation, I was behind her. At one point, that's when I think she struck me with her elbow. At that point, you don't want to get struck twice, so I was to the side and had my left leg kind of up against her, kind of bladed, like we're taught in law enforcement, not to leave my gun exposed towards her. Obviously, she's still got a hand that's free, so for me, I bladed myself, putting my gun away, like we're taught, and had my left leg kind of up against her, so my body's up against her, but it's not directly up against her front to back.
Okay. Now that you're located there, you recall where that camera is at this point?
Still in right hand, still video.
Right. And at some point, did you gain control of the camera?
I did. There was one point where I thought that the situation, I had, like I said, I had one hand behind her back. But I felt like at one point that she had basically lost focus for a second, that I could get the other hand behind her, other hand behind her back, so I did reach up and take her other hand behind her back.
Now, once you had your other hand behind your back, and you said you've seen the videos. How do you detain her at that point?
Just hold both hands behind her back.
Where are you in relation to her then, position-wise?
Same position, where my left leg is front. My back leg, my right leg is still kind of back to hold the position that I got there, same position.
At some point, did other deputies arrive?
They did.
All right, do you remember how long it took?
Not exactly. I mean, I know, you know, that's kind of a rural area in Dawson County, so you don't have officers always close by, hence the reason why they asked for an officer to be there at that event. It took a little while. I'm going to guess 10 minutes, but I really don't know. I mean, it could have been 15, it could have been longer. I know it wasn't. When you're in a situation, everything seems like an eternity, so I'm going to say probably, I'm going to guess, let's guess 15 minutes.
15 minutes. And you told me that you identified yourself to her. Do you remember how soon before the deputies arrived you identified yourself by your name?
Probably if it was 15 minutes, probably 5 to 7 minutes, somewhere in there.
Did you take, or what happened to the camera? That's what I asked.
The camera, at the time the incident occurred, or are you talking about after we left?
After the Ms. Tisdale, the other deputies have arrived.
Okay.
Let's back up. The deputies are up. Was she taken into custody?
She was.
Do you recall he took her into custody?
I believe Sergeant Russell Smith now, but I believe he was corporal at the time, come up and handcuffed her.
She put in a patrol car?
She was.
She had handcuffs on you.
I had handcuffs in the car, and that was probably a mistake that I had that day as far as not having them on me, but at the point where you control somebody, it would have been no different to hold both hands than it was to be able to have the handcuffs there. I wouldn't have been able to handcuff her until I got the second hand behind her back anyway, so the handcuffs would have done me no good until I could get both hands behind my back, behind her back. At that point, I would have continued to hold her. Even if I had handcuffs, I already gained control. I wouldn't have taken a chance to lose control again.
Why wouldn't you put her in the car?
My car I had at the time was not equipped with a cage, so there would be no way for her to be safe.
What the relevance of this is at this point, so I'm going to object.
It's relevant to what Ms. Tisdale testified in certain credibility, because he's impeaching what she said.
I didn't hear your testimony about
the cage.
Transport.
Right.
Well, not exactly what the line is, but I'll move on. Actually, I'm just done. Now, at any point did you grind your groin with your buttocks or anything?
Absolutely not.
At any point were you actually directly behind her when your groin was making contact with her?
The only time that it could be possible was, like I said, when I first took her over the counter there, where I pushed her over the counter. I would have been at that point right behind her, obviously, but I told you, I mean, many times we've been trained to keep our guns bladed away. I would never be directly behind. That's an officer safety issue, because through my training, I just don't do that, or I don't do that, and most officers I know don't either.
You said she looked right at you. Did you make eye contact when you were approaching to try to resolve the situation?
Yes, she looked straight at me.
Now, she's in the patrol car, and I think that's how I got offline there. What happened to the camera?
The camera was taken. I took the camera and turned it over to Laura Bishop, who was the deputy at the time with the Dawson County Sheriff's Office, for several reasons. One, I wanted it out of my possession. Two, I still had to stay at the event. I didn't know how much longer the event had. I didn't know at what point I'd be able to take that camera to turn it into evidence.
Did you turn it off, turn it on, anything like that?
Look, the one thing you got to know about me is I'm not technical. I don't know how that camera turns on and turns off, so whatever it was in that state, it's the way it stays.
Thank you.
in your eyes last night?
It does, you're correct. I know that both of us, you've been in law enforcement for a number of years, correct?
18 and a half.
Which is enough.
Yes.
And you have, as I understand it, performed similar functions at rallies before, correct?
Yes.
Including rallies at Burt's Farm, am I correct about that?
You're incorrect, I've never worked at a rally.
Never been at Burt's Farm before?
Not working a rally, I've been to Burt's Farm, but never at a rally.
Working as a deputy sheriff at a political rally?
I have not. I've been invited, but I've been out of the county for some.
So I'm going to confine my questions to that narrow focus.
I was just making sure you know, I've been there doing stuff, but not as a political rally.
But as I understand it, you have been detailed or volunteered to go to other political rallies where there were candidates and/or governors or other politicians, correct?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
And I would assume, correct me if I'm wrong, that every time you went to that kind of function, you wore the kind of outfit you wore on August 23rd of 2014?
Well, that would be a wrong assumption.
Okay.
Can I explain? Because you're asking a question, I'd like to explain why, because there is a difference in why we wear that uniform.
And I was just going to ask you that.
Okay.
But if I don't ask you the question, you can't explain, okay? I'm going to give you the opportunity.
I just want you to go to another question, not be able to explain that.
No, that wasn't.
I'm with you.
You explained that that was a somewhat of a seasonal outfit, as well as one that you would work, that you would use at a function like this.
Well, I mean, the decision to wear those type of uniforms is made based on the conditions. Like the night before, I'm not sure what I wore to an event the night before that was a political rally, but it was indoors and it was air conditioned. So the decision to wear khakis, polos, that kind of situation would be because it was outdoors. It's August, it's hot in Georgia in August.
Okay, so the decision as to what to wear, is that your decision?
It was.
Okay. And the other political rallies that you attended, did you always wear similar type clothing?
I think I just answered that. It depends on the situation and the environment that we're in.
Let's talk about the three or four rallies that you attended prior to this one. Do you have any recollection of those? You don't remember what you wore the night before, you just told us that.
Yeah, I don't know what I wore that one.
When was the previous time that you
I've been at locations with the governor before. That's been several years. I have no idea what I was wearing. I don't know if I was wearing the polo style or if I was wearing the Class A uniform.
Does the governor have his own security people?
He does.
So the governor travels with his own security people. Are they state patrol?
They are. They're basically state patrol just wearing a suit. You can't tell who they are. Basically, they're not in uniform either.
So the governor travels with his own security people. Do you know whether or not any other of the candidates or politicians travel with their own security? And how many folks, for example, do the governor, does security people, GBI, or state patrol officers, does he usually travel with?
I don't know that I can answer that, because I can tell you that I know how many I believe he travels with, but that may not be that accurate. They don't always come up to us and tell us all their ins and outs secrets of what they have there. I can give you my best guess, but I can't tell you for sure.
Well, suffice it to say that you know that he does travel with security. You don't know how many there were that evening, or really any other time, right?
I don't know how many there were. I know he had at least one that day.
And as I understand it, you've been to other political rallies, correct?
Yeah, I mean, that's the ones I thought about working in.
Okay. And when you worked there, have you worked in both public events and private events?
I really don't. Well, I think one time our governor did, I was at a public place. I was at one of the technical colleges, and I was asked to go down there as extra security. I think that's the only time that I was in a public place. I think the others have been more privately owned locations.
In the privately owned, let's talk about the public location. Did you or were you aware how that event was promoted?
I was not.
At the event on privately owned property, were you aware how they were promoted?
I don't usually look at how people market or promote. Obviously, at some point during those weeks, I was either asked or told. I was in civic clubs here in Dawson County. I was at the sheriff's office. A lot of people knew me. They may have called me, met me, read the paper. I have no idea how I knew.
So the answer is no, you don't know how they were promoted?
That's what I said. No, I just wanted to clarify.
You said a little bit more.
Well, I wanted to clarify why I didn't know, or how I may have known. It's a complicated question.
Well, sure. Cause for an answer of no, you weren't asked why you didn't know. You volunteered why you didn't know.
To make sure I clarify that I probably did know, but I don't know how I did know.
Well, then let's talk about the event on August 25th. At either of the public or private events that you were before, were there any restrictions on who could come?
I have no idea.
Were there any restrictions on whether or not the press was invited?
I have no idea.
Were there any restrictions on whether or not people could either record or film?
I have no idea.
And now let's talk about this particular event. You had been contacted some time before.
I was.
By Mr. Bearden, correct?
Correct.
And Mr. Bearden had texted you, as I understand what you said.
Yes, sir.
He had texted you some time before and wanted to see if you would ask the sheriff to allow you to come to this event.
He wanted to know if we were having somebody at the event.
Well, yeah, to see if it would be possible to have a deputy at Burt's farm. Right?
I guess. I can't remember exactly what the text is verbatim, but something to that effect.
Okay. And do you recall telling him that you had already planned to be there?
I have to look at the text messages. I know that I told him that I would be coming at some point, but I'd be happy to look at the text messages and explain it to you. Another page. Hold on a second. Yeah, I don't know how far before I said it, I was planning on being at the event.
Well, the first text to you was from Clint Beard, correct?
Yes, it looks like.
Asking you if you could see if there was a deputy.
Sure.
That was going to be there, right? And then that's your response, right? I plan on being there. I was already on top of it.
I was. I'm trying to explain to you. I was planning on being there. I was planning on going on or off duty regardless. I was planning on being at the event. That I, on top of it, meant I'd already planned to talk to the sheriff about the governor coming to town.
Okay, I mean, that's fine.
Okay, I'm just going to make sure I clarify for you.
The event was at Burt's farm, correct?
What?
The event, however, was a public event, correct?
I believe they invited the public.
Yes. Pardon?
So I believe they invited the public, correct?
Okay. And there was no question that it was a public event, correct?
Yeah, asked the public to come, yes.
Okay. And you understood, did you not, that Clint Bearden told you that there was an ad, and once the ad stated all are welcome, it became a public event?
I've already told you I have no idea how they advertised.
Well, in this part of the text, training that you have with Mr. Bearden?
That isn't like the text that I exchanged with Mr. Bearden, no.
Okay. Well, you have no...
Is that not the text that was sent to me from a female, can't remember her name, but I don't believe that the text that was sent to me by Mr. Bearden, no.
Okay. You understand, though, that once an ad is placed, inviting the public, it is a public event, correct?
I've heard this, you know, obviously been in the courtroom, so I'd like to clarify since you're asking me what I think. I believe when you invite somebody to the public, yes, it does become, or you've asked the public to come, but I don't believe that in any way on private property gives, that makes it all welcome regardless to what you want to do. So I give the example, like, even though you say all are welcome, I really doubt with the governor and congressman there, they were.
Excuse me, that's fine. I didn't ask for an explanation of your thoughts.
Okay, can I explain? He asked me a question, my opinion.
You've already explained.
Your Honor, answer the question.
What was the question? Was it a public event?
Yes.
You wouldn't know whether I believe it was a public event once it had been asked, that the public's invited. That's asking my opinion. I'd just like to explain my opinion.
Well, what, is that a, will you need to give an answer, yes or no?
I can't give yes or no. I still believe that there's a, is a yes with a cause to have other indications that you don't want other people there.
Right, well, what were the indications that you had, that you saw? One, were there any indications prior to the time that you arrived that indicated to you that there were people that were not welcome?
I didn't see anything that said you were.
Was there any policy that you saw that said people were not welcome?
No.
Was there any statement by Mr. or Mrs. Burt that people were not welcome?
No.
Was there any statement by any of the candidates prior to the time that you arrived to you?
No.
That people were not welcome?
No.
Did you see any signs posted that people or anybody was not welcome?
Not that no.
Did you post anything that said any people are not welcome?
Did I post anything?
Yes, did you post anything?
I didn't post anything about it at all.
All right. Did you make any announcement to anybody that certain people
no.
or professions were not welcome?
No.
Did you hear anybody else at the beginning of the rally say that people, certain people, aren't welcome to the public?
I didn't hear the introduction.
Okay.
I heard nothing else.
So was there any registration table?
Not that I know.
To sign in to get in?
Not that I know.
Was there anybody standing at the door taking an entrance fee or an admittance fee?
Not that I know.
Was there anything to suggest that it was not open to the public prior to the time that you arrived and when you first arrived?
That's where I guess we would have to agree to disagree. I think that to answer your question, I need more than yes or no answer.
What policy did you see?
I didn't answer my question.
What rules or regulations?
I answered that question. Didn't see any.
Were you provided any rules or regulations by anybody?
Not that I can recall.
So what? Okay. Let's leave it at that. And you didn't see any of the advertising or internet presence or any of the announcements of the event prior to you getting there?
As I said earlier, I don't know how I knew it was there. I don't know if I saw it in the paper. I don't know if I heard about it from somebody. I can't answer that because I don't know. That is the answer. I don't know.
Did you see Ms. Tisdale when she arrived?
I did not.
Okay.
Not that I'm aware of, anyway.
Okay. How early did you arrive?
I think the event started at 3:30. I think I got there somewhere around 3 o'clock, maybe a little bit before.
Okay. And was, when you arrived, who, if you can recollect, were the candidates that were already there?
Already there?
Yeah.
That's a hard question for me, because some of the candidates I have no interest in, don't know who they were. So, I mean, I knew they were candidates, but I couldn't tell you who was there.
That's what I said, if you know.
Yeah, I know.
Do you recall and do you know when Senator Perdue came in?
I saw him at some point, but I don't recall the time.
Well, you know, you were asked about the video, the court has seen the video, and we talked about the video, not really not been played yet. Okay. I don't like you didn't play it. Yeah. You saw Senator Perdue arrive.
At some point, yes.
Yes. You saw him enter where the meeting lead was, correct?
I don't know. Are you talking about the video?
Yes.
Yeah, it's on the video, yes.
And you saw that Ms. Tisdale was filming him, correct?
On the video, yes.
And you saw Mr. and Mrs. Burt and their greeting, now Senator Perdue, correct?
I saw them talking. I don't know who they were talking to.
You know, when you were performing your security duties, I guess at that particular point, where were you located?
I was all over the place. I mean, you have people coming in from the parking lot, so I spent time in the parking lot. once different candidates started arriving, I followed behind, followed in, then I would, you know, once they seemed like they were mingling or safe, I went back outside, signed all over the place. I mean, I was in the barn and the area known as the Gore Shack and the parking lot, I was in several places.
But you weren't there when Senator Purdue came into the meet and greet?
I don't know.
Okay.
I mean, I could have been behind them, I could have been just on the other side of the frame of the cameras, I don't know.
How about Governor Deal? Were you there when Governor Deal came?
I don't recall where I was.
Well, did you see him arrive?
I don't remember when I saw him arrive. I know that Governor Deal at some point arrived, and though I was around Governor Deal at some point after he arrived, but I don't remember where I was when he arrived.
Okay, that's what I was asking.
Okay.
And you don't remember what time he arrived?
I don't.
How about Attorney General Owens?
I don't even know if I knew who Sam Owens was before that day.
Okay. Did you see, well, obviously, you didn't see him because you didn't know who he was?
I could have saw him, I still don't know who he was.
Yeah, that's all right.
Could have talked to him, could have shook his hand, but I just don't know who he was.
Okay. Now, while you were walking around, you didn't encounter Ms. Tisdale, correct?
Not that I'm aware of, but I may have saw her, like I said, I mean, nothing that was stood out to make me be able to remember seeing her at another location, though.
Okay, sure. And if she arrived earlier and walked around and talked with folks, that's nothing that you would have any knowledge of, correct?
Could have seen her, could not have, I don't know.
You weren't present for any conversation that she may or may not have had with Mrs. Burt?
Not at all.
Okay. And as I understand it, prior to the time of this particular event, you had no contact with her, no knowledge of her, or any other encounter with her, correct?
Like I said, not that I know of. She didn't stand out. I don't remember seeing her anywhere else at the event, but at some point, I'm sure we walked by each other or somewhere in the vicinity, because it's not like a huge area, so.
Well, did you see, the event started with Mr. Bearden introducing the speakers?
I believe so.
Oh, that?
I believe so.
Report?
So I do believe so. I was right there. I watched the video. It looks like that's a good situation, catches.
And if you recall, Mr. Bearden didn't introduce himself.
No, I did. Other than watching the video, I didn't see it in the video.
Okay. Didn't introduce himself and didn't introduce himself as anybody related to either Burt's farm or anybody.
Not that I heard in the video.
Okay. And in fact, I think he said, "Welcome to Burt's Farm. We want to thank them for being the hosts, and we're going to get to the speakers." Right?
I guess. I mean,
whatever
the video shows is, okay. I guess, the same thing. But I'm going to tell you, I wasn't standing at that right by them at that location. So I'm going based on the video that y'all have shown. That's the same thing I said.
So did that refresh your recollection as to what happened?
Refresh my recollection, because I just said I wasn't there when Clint Bearden. I was still different areas of the property, so I didn't recollect because I wasn't at that particular location at the time.
Okay. Now, Ms. Tisdale was sitting in the front row, correct?
I think not in the front row, somewhere in that front area.
You did encounter her.
Did.
Are you saying you don't remember whether she was on the first row or second row?
When I walk up to somebody, I don't count how many chairs are in front or behind.
So the answer is no. You don't recollect what row she was on.
I just said I think she was close to the front, if not in front row, the one of the front right there. That's what I said when I was asked by both of you.
The answer is no.
The answer is exactly what I just said.
When you first saw her, she was filming, correct?
When I saw her, when I was walking towards her, she was filming, correct?
Did you see her before that?
I told you I don't know the answer to that question. We may have saw each other, we may not have, I don't know.
No, I'm talking about during the speeches. We're at the speeches. We're talking about Mr. Bearden has introduced the speaker. Ms. Tisdale is in the front. You have no idea. You don't remember whether she was on the front row, the second row, or the third row.
I didn't say that. Okay. I said she was either in the front or close to the front.
Right, that's what you said.
Yes, but I didn't say front, second, third.
Did you see her?
I did, at some point I walked up to her, that's what I'm saying. I don't know what point you're asking me when I seen her, that's what I'm asking.
You didn't see her before you walked up to her?
I don't know what point we saw each other when she walks in. I've answered that question. I don't know what you're asking.
After the speeches started.
After the speeches started. I would, at the point.
Can I finish my question?
Sure, I was trying to answer the question.
Ken, after Mr. Bearden, and while Mr. Bearden was introducing the speakers, did you see Ms. Tisdale recording?
Okay, let me answer this one more time, because I've answered this several times. At the point that Mr. Bearden was introducing those speakers, I don't know where I was. I could have been standing there close by, I could have been in the bar area. I can't answer that with a yes or no, because I don't know where I was. So you said swear to tell the truth, I'm telling the truth.
Did you see her recording the first speaker?
I did not, not to know of.
Did you see her recording the second speaker?
I don't know. I don't know. I was told, I became aware she was recording.
Your answer is, I don't know.
Okay, I don't know.
Did you see her start recording the third speaker?
I don't know what order the speakers were. So if I can elaborate, I'd be happy to answer the question, but I don't remember the order of the speakers. And to be honest with you, most of these events, I don't listen to the speakers.
Did you see anybody go talk to Ms. Tisdale prior to the time you talked to her?
Yes. Let's take it earlier. Can we answer it?
Now, who did you see first go speak with her?
I believe that would be the Mac subject. The subject, his first name was Mac, I believe.
Okay. And if you saw him go speak to her, what was she doing while he talked to her?
What was she doing? She was recording.
Okay, and she was holding the camera, correct?
Sure.
The camera was pointed at the at the candidate.
Absolutely.
So you did see her and see where she was recording during the speeches.
I just said I don't know which speaker it was. I did see her during the speakers, right, but I don't know which one.
And Mr. Burgess, you believe, is the first person that went up to her, correct?
I believe.
And how long did he talk with her?
I don't know, because when I saw him, he was finished. You know, I don't know when he got there, so I can't give you the answer when he did. But
and did you see him get out?
I saw him walk away from her.
Okay. And he walked away from her, and in which direction did he walk?
Towards me.
Right. Did he come to you?
Did he come to me? No.
Right. Did he talk with you?
Yes.
How did he talk with you without coming to you?
He didn't come to me. We were passing each other. I stopped him.
Okay. You stopped him?
Yeah. I'm trying to clarify. He didn't walk to go see me. Okay. We were walking in the same general area when I stopped to talk to him.
Okay. And you talked with him?
I did.
After you talked with him, where did you go?
Back to that same general area that was right there, next to the seating on the far side, I guess.
Okay. Had you seen or observed Ms. Tisdale making any loud noises at the time?
No, sir.
Saying anything?
Not that I know.
Asking any questions?
Not that I know.
Do you recall who was seated behind her or around her?
I know at some point that Clint Bearden was behind her when he was talking to her.
But you didn't observe whether anybody else was behind her taking pictures or audio recording?
I don't remember anybody else recording your photograph or anything else, no.
Do you remember where Governor Deal and his wife
were? Somewhere in that close proximity, but I can't remember exactly where they were.
Governor Deal was on the right side and close to the speakers, correct?
As I just said, I don't recall exactly where they're sitting, so it's hard to say correctly.
Well, one of your tasks, of course, is to watch the candidates.
Sure, correct? But 2 years later, it's hard to remember where everybody was sitting.
Sure. Do you remember any other candidates that were near the speakers or around the pickup truck? That was the focal point of
at some point I saw David Perdue. I don't know if I saw David Perdue, but I saw Congressman Doug Collins at that area.
I mean, one of your functions, of course, is to provide security for the candidates, right?
Sure.
So one of the things you want to do is keep tabs on where the candidates are.
And I would have at the time, but I can't remember 2 years ago where the seating room chart was then.
Sure. Now, you had a brief encounter with Mr. Burgess. Who was the next person you saw talk with Ms. Tisdale?
Clint Bearden.
was Clint Bearden when Clint Bearden talked to Ms. Tisdale?
Sitting, I guess, kind of behind her.
And do you recall how long that encounter lasted?
It was short, I don't recall how long it was.
You couldn't hear any of that encounter?
Could not.
Of course. After that encounter, Clint Bearden came back, as far as I understand, and did he talk with you?
No, that went all the way over and started talking to Ms. Tisdale.
Okay. When you came, when Clint Bearden came back, Clint Bearden didn't talk with you?
I don't remember if Clint Bearden came back, so I mentioned, I don't remember.
And do you remember whether Clint Bearden went to Ms. Tisdale's location after that?
After he talked to her?
Yes.
No.
Back with you?
No, I don't recall him going with me.
So as I understand it, you're the only person that went back?
I didn't say that. I said I don't recall him going with me.
Okay. Well, was there, do you recall anybody else going with you?
I know I walked up. I don't know if somebody walked up behind me. I wasn't, I don't have eyes in my chair.
Do you know whether Clint Bearden was behind Ms. Tisdale?
I just said I don't know.
And Ms. Tisdale, when you walked up to her, was still recording, correct?
She was.
And that recorder has a microphone on it.
Does?
And you've heard and seen some of the recordings, correct?
You hear muffled sounds of people talking, but you can't hear what's been said.
Okay. There's a very short period of some muffled conversation on that recording, correct?
Yes.
But as you said, you couldn't tell what you said, or you couldn't tell anything that she said, correct?
On the recording?
Yeah, on the recording.
I can tell on the recording.
Okay. And maybe I'm mistaken, but I think that you said that the conversation was pretty short.
I said approximately 25 seconds, maybe 30.
Okay. And in those 30 seconds, we've got no sound, no recording, no conversation, correct?
Well, you're the muffled speaking. I'm assuming that's me and her just talking. I can't.
And I understand that you came up on the left-hand side of her.
I came up to her left, kind of the left front, as I explained, probably between 10 and 11 o'clock.
And how close were you to her?
Very.
And you were speaking to her?
Yes.
Now, she was still holding the recorder in her right hand?
Yes, sir.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Did you say, "Hi, I'm Clint Bearden with the Sheriff's Department"?
What is it, Clint Bearden? Because I'm not Clint Bearden.
I mean, I'm sorry. Tony Wooten or Captain Wooten?
I told you before I came up and I told her I was with the Sheriff's Office. I can't recall if I said Tony Wooten.
All right. And as I understand it, did she, when you say she refused, did she say the owner or Mrs. Burt gave me permission?
She said I have the owner's permission, and she told me no.
Okay. So when you said the owner, according to you, the owner said that she couldn't record, she responded by saying, "I have the owner's permission."
And I responded by saying I just left the owner, and they told me to tell you that you needed to either stop or leave.
And when you say she refused, again, what did she respond?
No.
Nothing?
No. She said no.
No. Okay. And was that no really loud?
I'm not a judge of how many decibels people talk. I mean, I understood her saying no.
Well, we couldn't even hear it on the...
That's what I said. I don't know how loud it was. I know that she said no.
And you said, well, I'm going to take you out and you're going to go to jail.
I told her that she had three options. It was to stop recording and stay, or if she could leave, like they asked her to do, and if she didn't want to do either, then she was, there's the other option, she could go to jail.
Okay. And at that point, did she respond?
She did not.
Okay. So you did what at that point?
Like I said before, I placed one hand in her hand, camera area, another on her arm, and the point she jumped out.
So your left hand went in front of the camera?
I'm assuming that's my hand. I know I went for that hand area there, so I must have, yeah.
Because we can see...
That's what I said. I assume that's my hand.
All right. And your right hand went to where?
Under her arm. On her arm.
On her, it would be on her left arm.
Could have been.
Well, if you were on her left side.
Could have been her right arm. I could reach across, but I think it was her left arm.
Well, if you had your left hand in front of the camera and you're on her left side, you're reaching to her left arm.
That's what I said, I believe that's so. It could have been the right arm where she had the camera. I can't remember the time.
And it was after you grabbed her left arm that she came out of her seat, correct?
Yes, at that point she stood up.
Okay, so she stood up. She stood up voluntarily because you had her camera blocked. And
well, I didn't say it was voluntarily. I said she stood up.
Okay, did you pull her up?
I was going to lift her up at the same time she stood up. So it would be both me pulling her up and her getting up.
And then you were escorting her out of the location of the barn where the...
Sure.
Okay. Now, it was you escorting her out, correct?
Sure.
She wasn't voluntarily going with you.
Absolutely not. She was fighting.
She was fighting because she's a tough lady.
There's a violating the law.
Objection, Judge. If she's a tough lady, that's coming to her.
You, you were, in fact, forcibly taking her out of that location.
Sure.
And you were forcibly taking her out of that location by attempting to, as best as you could, physically restrain her, correct?
Explain that for me, that way I can make sure I answered like you like.
Well, you had a hold of her arm.
Sure.
You were exercising the third option.
I was removing her, yes.
Okay. Well, you told us that there were three options. The last one was you go into jail.
Sure.
She had not responded to you. She responded twice saying she had permission.
She said no.
Or she said no. And then you were exercising the third option.
I've asked three times and she's refusing to do anything until we know.
She was clearly taken and escorted by you in your custody at that particular point, correct?
Escorted as she fought.
She was clearly in your custody at that particular point, correct?
I was trying to, yes.
Okay. And you physically had taken a hold of her and were physically escorting her to the another location, correct?
I've answered that several times. I was,
so the answer is yes?
Well, the answer is yes, and as she was fighting with me, wasn't that? But I've answered it several times. I don't know how to answer it for you. Some point, because she's in the photo filming that way.
Well, do you recognize that as the candidate that was speaking when you engaged?
I think so, but like I said, I don't pay attention to all these candidates that we see once in our life.
Right, but is that the way she was holding her camera?
When I approached, she was holding her, yes.
What's been marked as plaintiff 16, defendant 16, 17, and 18. If you would look at those. Do those do those photographs accurately represent you with Ms. Tisdale taking her to the, I guess the counter?
Can you explain what accurately? Sure, can we explain what accurately represents?
Yes, are they photographs that show the activities of you taking this?
Shows the activities of me escorting her, fighting both, yes.
Sure. I guess that you heard her continually say, please identify yourself.
I did.
Did you identify yourself?
Not at that point. I did after we got out of the barn, after she calmed down, after the one point after I had her trained.
Sure. So my question was, did you identify yourself at that time?
Which time were we talking about?
When she was saying, please identify yourself.
Not the time between the court and the barn.
Right. So she was continually saying, please identify yourself.
Correct.
At that point, she was also saying that she had talked to the owner. Correct.
Not at the time, or I don't remember if there's a time that she's being escorted out, if she said that, I don't remember that.
And when you got her to the counter, she was continuing to say, I talked to the owner, correct?
Yeah, she said she talked to Captain Burt. Yes, then okay. Mr. Burt come in and said that she had not.
No. Did you listen to the video?
Several times.
Okay. He didn't say you had not. He said, I'm the owner.
Okay.
Well, and I say no.
I was busy restraining your client. I have no idea exactly what all I got
to say. But you can listen to a video.
Sure.
And you can accurately
repeat it. If you play it, I'll be able to tell you accurately.
Instead of making up stuff.
I didn't make up stuff. I'm going by my best reaction.
Is that a question or a lecture?
Both.
Ask a question.
It wasn't a question.
Okay. You understood, you saw on the video that he said, I am the owner and I say no.
I guess. I don't remember exactly what all he said.
Well, it's important, isn't it? The words that are used.
That's why I think you ask him. He told you what he said. It's on the video.
And you reviewed the video, correct?
I have. I've seen the video.
And it's important that words that you say in court are accurate, correct?
It is. That's why I'm trying to explain. I don't know exactly what got said. I didn't say it. He did.
When you got to the barn, or to the counter, to the checkout counter, as they call it, one of the things that you do, I guess, as a law enforcement officer, is to restrain as much as possible whatever subject you have. As much as possible, correct?
No, depends on the subject, how much that subject's resisting. You have some people that's under arrest that walk off, and you have very little physical control at all.
Okay, well, here's what you did with Miss Tisdale, as I recall. You had her arm, correct?
I did.
And you had her, I guess, her right arm or her left arm?
Left arm at the time that we entered, so at some point I had both, but at one point it was left arm.
All right. Let me hand you what's been marked as defendant's exhibit 24. Let's see if you can identify that.
Okay.
Is that an accurate representation of you and Ms. Tisdale at the checkout counter?
Sure, I guess at some point, yes.
Okay. She is face forward, correct?
She is.
She is bent over the checkout counter, correct?
Yes.
Right. And you have a hold of her right arm behind her back?
That point, yes.
I beg your pardon?
Yes, at that point, right.
Okay. And you are behind her.
Well, actually to the side of her, as the picture clearly shows.
Picture clearly shows, but it would show.
Let's what it looks like to me. You asked me what I thought it looked like, so answer your question.
All right, I move introduction of defendant's exhibit number 24.
Admitted.
And then get your chart, yeah.
I think at one point, Ms. Tisdale says to you, I'm not going anywhere. You know, you don't have to put my arms behind my back. Do you remember her saying that?
Not that I recall, but I mean, we're continuously fighting, so regardless of what she said, her actions would have meant that I couldn't release her. I mean, you don't fight somebody, they continue to fight, and you release them while they're fighting.
Excuse me, person.
Oh yeah, she said, I'll leave. That's what she said. And then I said, sure. You know, we're past that. I mean, you've already kicked me, elbowed me.
Was there anybody else there when that was said?
I don't know.
Was Mr. Burt there? Was Mrs. Burt there?
I still don't know.
Did you hear anybody say, well, you know, we don't want to take her to jail?
I think at one point Mr. Burt come in and talked to me, and I said, you know, it's too late. She's already hit me, kicked me. I mean, at some point, you know, there's a line after you use physical force to remove somebody and they use physical force to resist, the option of have a good day and hope you enjoy lunch is probably gone.
Okay. I know that you were abused during this exchange. Did you?
I didn't say abused. I said I was a kid.
Did you seek any medical attention?
Didn't.
Did you take any pictures?
Didn't have any visible injuries that required pictures.
Yeah, and that's the same with the elbowing that you may have gotten.
I did get an elbow, and I might have gotten, and I didn't have any visible injuries that required a photograph, as I said.
And I know that you have never encountered subjects that were alleging that they are being illegally arrested. You've never had that happen before, correct?
Well, there's always people that decide that they're going to fight and say that they don't want to go to jail.
Sure. And those people that were doing that, had you seen people committing a crime before?
Have I seen people committing a crime? Absolutely.
And you've arrested those people, correct?
Yes. Some have been released. I mean, I guess it depends on the crime and which incident we're talking about.
And I guess the crime that you saw Ms. Tisdale commit was filming quietly, the candidates.
No, I'd be happy to explain. I saw her committing the crime of criminal trespass after being asked by three separate people to stop recording her leave. After being identified as a sheriff's office employee, and I've asked her to leave three separate times, she committed the offense of criminal trespass, not quietly recording and asked to leave.
I see. You don't know what Mr. Burgess said to her.
I said I didn't.
You don't know what Mr. Bearden said.
Other than what they testified to.
I also understand that at that particular point, at that point while Ms. Tisdale was still filming, that was the point where she asked you to identify yourself as well.
Which point was she still filming?
When you were picking her up and taking her and leaving.
She didn't ask me to identify herself at that point that I recall. And I didn't pick her up, as I said. She stood up at the same time that I had a hold of her arm.
You what's been marked as defendants 25 26, 27, 28.
And I handed those and see if you can identify those as
Sure.
stills from the video.
They do appear to be made from the video, yes.
Judge, I move to admit 25, 26, 27, and 28.
No objection.
I'm going to hand those up to you, please. Yeah, tell me please, Mr. Wooten, first, we have been talking about, two particular physical events. One that you were kicked in the shin, correct?
Yes.
Where did that occur? When did that occur during this exchange?
Coming into the barn area from outside.
Coming into the, where the checkout counter is area?
Coming into it, well, it was outside of that area, still outside the barn, I guess.
Okay. And tell us of which leg you were kicked with.
Which leg I was kicked with? I don't know, I was kicked in both shins.
Okay, in both shins?
Yes.
All right. And when you were kicked in both shins, outside that area, was anybody else there?
Sure, there's people walking by my hands full trying to restrain your client.
Okay. And you were attempting to restrain her, correct?
Was.
All right. And I guess that she just hauled off and sort of kicked you.
Well, it's not real hard to kick somebody when you have their arms and their feet are free. So, yeah, she kicked me with her legs, with her feet.
The back of her foot or the front of her foot?
Sir, I didn't look down. I tried to continue to move her to the area of the barn.
And I'm assuming that there was a continuous physical contact with you and Ms. Tisdale during this encounter, you're taking her to the checkout counter area.
I mean, continuous as far as me still having her hand behind her back and escorting to that area?
Well, yeah.
Yeah, still in contact.
And she was twisting around.
Yeah.
Okay, is what you told me. And you were pushing her, correct?
I was trying to escort her.
Right.
She was trying to get away, and I was trying to push her in that direction.
She had one arm on her cam, correct? Right?
Sure.
And you physically had her and were pushing her in a particular direction, correct?
Tempting to, yes. I was making my headway, but it was slowly.
And she was continuously during this particular period asking for you to identify yourself, correct?
She was. But I already said I identified myself before with physical conversation started, and I identified myself after she was restrained and stopped fighting.
So the answer to my question is yes, during this period,
sure, she's still
she was continuing to request you to identify yourself.
Absolutely.
Right. And she was twisting around, right?
Yeah, she was twisting, trying to get away, making movements like she was trying to get away from me.
Okay. And you physically guided her into the checkout counter area, I guess the bar area, right?
Yes.
And you physically put her over the counter, correct? Now, where was the elbow?
Well, after we got in the barn area there, when we were still, wasn't like she went over the counter and nothing else happened. So there was still some physical altercation that took place there at that point.
Okay.
Sometime near the point, I don't know at what point, how I can answer that.
Well,
after she was placed over the counter there, it wasn't that she stayed there. She came up, her body was flailing sideways, different directions. She was turned around at points, looking at me, points that she wasn't looking at me, so during that time.
Okay, well, we can see on the video that she was over the counter. She was yelling, essentially, that she had been given permission, that she had talked to Kathy Burt, correct?
Sure.
She was saying, at least at one point, you're hurting me, correct?
She was.
She yelled very loudly, at least, I know, six times, correct?
Sure.
All right. You didn't hear that on the video, correct?
Did I not hear it on the video?
Yeah,
she yelled continuously. I know there's parts in the video where she didn't yell. We talked calmly after the video stopped. I know there's a lot of things that happened in there. I know at points that she was yelling, there was no other force used that was used when she wasn't yelling. So I'm not sure why she'd be yelling.
What arm did she elbow you with?
I believe it was her right once we got inside the barn there, once we were trying to make an attempt to get her to the county.
Right, sure. That's the one that... On defendant's exhibit number 24, that's the one that you've got a hold of.
At the point that you showed me this here, I told you that I escorted her out, I believe, holding her left arm. So at some point, her left arm must have become free and struggled inside, and I've got her right arm at this point.
Okay. That's inside the checkout counter, right?
It's in the barn area.
She's bent over at that particular time, correct?
Of the picture you're talking about? I can't really tell. I mean, she could be, I mean, depending on how the barn, the thing is, I guess she's still laying on it.
And you have, at this particular point, her right arm in your grasp,
sure.
Correct? Okay. But that's the arm that she elbowed you with?
I believe so when we come in. But I didn't have her right arm, obviously, behind her back when she elbowed me. Can I finish?
Yep.
Yeah. Because at one point, I obviously would have had her left hand, and you can see at this point, I don't have her left hand. During her struggle, one hand came free, and I got another hand.
No, it's not obvious which hand you had, because you don't remember which hand.
I told you that I had your left hand outside and that right hand here, so it's pretty obvious we switched at some point.
Well, I didn't notice. When did you switch?
At some point during the struggle. Obviously, her left hand is not behind her back. Her right hand is.
So, as I understand it, then both the shin kicking and the elbowing occurred when you were coming in.
That's not what I said. I said the shin kicking happened outside the barn area.
Right. And the elbowing.
Inside the barn area after the continued struggle happened at the area of the cashier's checkout.
And when you were bringing her into the checkout area, that elbowing you believe to be the right arm.
Correct? Yes.
And we don't know what foot kicked you in either shin, correct?
I promise you I didn't look down and see which one it was.
Who else was there when you brought her in?
Like I said, sir, I have no idea. I mean, I didn't look around when you're in the middle of a confrontation, somebody struggling, elbowing you, kicking, you're not trying to see. Let me make sure I get all the list of people that are in here at the same time.
Right. And when you got in there, how long was it before Mr. Burt, Johnny Burt, came in?
Not very long. I believe that his daughter was in there at some point. I know, I can't remember who was in there at different points. Obviously, you know, for those guys that were standing around, I was a little busy.
When you talked with Johnny Burt, did I understand you to say Johnny Burt said, what did he say?
Something to the effect, I don't know exactly, something to the effect of, can we let her go or something like that, I can't remember.
Okay. Right. That was
exactly that answer. Seriously,
Johnny Burt was your witness?
How's it about make it hearsay? I'm sorry, Judge.
He's already testified, and you have the opportunity to ask him those questions.
Then he can get called, and it's still hearsay to come from Captain Wooten. It's offered for the truth of the matter asserted. It's still hearsay.
Okay, he's already testified.
And that makes it okay how?
Because you had the opportunity.
He was set. You can recall him if you want to.
But it's still hearsay.
Denied. But I go over with the objection.
That was while you were in the checkout counter area, correct?
Sure, yes.
And that was also, was that before he said, I'm the owner, and I said no?
I can't recall.
Was it when Mr. Burt was close to where you were?
And he would have been in the barn area, so I don't know the distance, but he was in the barn area. So, okay. Yeah.
And if you were communicating with him, we could or should be able to hear that on the video, correct?
As I've said several times, that videotape is nowhere near as long as the actual conversation happened inside the barn here. There's a period where that videotape is obviously turned off, however it got turned off. And there's still a great period of time between that and the end. I don't know what point that Mr. Burt said, it's, if it wasn't on the video, it must be probably after the video stopped.
Okay. And at that particular point, you responded that it's too late for that.
Did. I responded, it's too late for that. She's kicked me, insulted me, we've had to use force, she's resisted. Whole gamut of things was said, not just too late.
One moment, please. I also understood that you stayed with the Dawson County Sheriff's Office until recently, correct?
Sure, about 6 weeks ago, I guess.
You also were there, and you talked earlier about policy. Was there a policy change in the Dawson County Sheriff's Office about the attire that folks were to wear at public events?
I can't recall.
Can't recall.
You ask, I answer, I can't recall.
That's all I have at this time, Judge. Thank you.
Mr. Greer.
No further questions today.
Mr. Deputy, Mr. Greer.
Thank you.
I have no more rebuttal witnesses today.
Sir?
I don't have any more rebuttal motion, witnesses for this motion.
Yeah. I don't have any more witnesses for this motion.
All right.